The Barry Switzer Show. Barry Switzer Show is brought to you by the people of Kerr-McGee Corporation, putting natural resources to work for you. Now here's Barry with Steve Davis.
Hi, welcome again to our show. The Sooners won another one this week, 38-14 over the Kansas Jayhawks in Lawrence, Kansas. And now it's the OSU Cowboys.
Really is, Coach. Momentum is such a big part of a football game. It seems like this team had its struggles early. Momentum is really seeming on your side now.
Well, we've done some good things. When you win, that's what you call momentum. And
momentum.
When you don't win, it's called no-mentum. But we've got some momentum going right now, and I think that we're a much better football team, Steve, than we were several weeks ago. And the reason why, we've practiced and we've played, we've had some success, we're better now as individual players, and we're doing some things on offense that has helped us, and we've settled down some areas on defense. So we're a much better total defensive and offensive unit today.
Offensively, it's just like old times. You had over 500 yards, you six different running backs. It was just like wishbone eye formation. Doesn't make a whole lot of difference. That's got to be a compliment.
Well, I tell you, I've always said it's never the alignment. It's the talent you have in the alignment. It's the alignee in the alignment that makes you win, whether it's wishbone or eye formation or conventional pro set, whatever you line up and want to play. If you got the talent, you can be successful. And we have got good running backs, and those guys have all doing a good job. That's why I'm playing them all. We're not a one-back offense. We're not an offense that will line up. OSU has an outstanding back in Ernest Anderson. We'll talk about him later. He carries the ball like we gave it to old Steve Owens years ago, 40 times a game. We have got backs we feel are a threat. All of them are threats, and they all should carry the football, and I think it makes us a better offense because we give it to our fullback 25 to 30 times a game, plus the eye backs are being in the wishbone. Those halfbacks will carry it 30 times a game.
Well, it's a lot of fun when you win. We've got your plays of the week, Coach. Barry's play of the week.
I know one of them what it'll be.
I bet you do, too.
I haven't even seen it, but it should be the first play that Marcus Dupree's in the ball game. The freshman from Philadelphia, Mississippi, has good blocking, breaks off tackle, and hits the boundary and right in front of their bench. And I know what they got to think, the coaches and players over there. And, to be 6'2" and 230 pounds and run 9'5" and use karate, too, that's just not fair. He just hit the guy in the throat and went down and collapsed. He broke his knees. At 75 yards in the first play, and here we are, Kelly Phelps in the option play, and Kelly jumps up inside the end, and Marcus is in pitch position, and Kelly, off the option play, runs about 17 yards on a touchdown drive here. It was a big play in the game, and took a drive in and scored with that. Here's Kelly handing the ball to Freddie Sims. Quick little Freddie breaks outside. He was supposed to be on the show last week, never showed, but there he is. He made it anyway. He's running the football for us. He's a good back. Here's the ball been handed off to Stanley Wilson, and number 32, Stanley breaks up inside, breaks some tackles, keeps his balance, and good tough running for about a 20-yard gain there. Stanley had 100 yards in the ball game against Kansas. Kelly hands the ball. We had a lot of big plays. I just thought we were going to look at a couple of them. There's Marcus Dupree on the off-tackle play. He powers for about 13 yards for a touchdown here. Second touchdown of three that day, and I think out of the wishbone now. You'll see out of the wishbone, quick pitch, and Marcus here cuts back inside, good block on the corner, outruns that guy, and cuts back inside, puts it in the end zone, a 7-yard touchdown run. Good offense. 570 yards, that's the most Kansas has ever had put on them, Steve. But a week from now, they're going to have that broken. Nebraska comes to town.
The record will last till Nebraska.
Yeah, it'll last till Nebraska comes to town. Here's Sanji making two of his interceptions. He actually had a third, but it doesn't count when you intercept the pass on a two-point play, and he runs it back 50 yards. He's wanting to do his wind sprint. Sauer, their quarterback. Frank Sauer, a very talented quarterback from Edison High School in Huntington Beach, California. Good defense, good pass rush. Danny Wilson, Jr. from Sherman, Texas, makes the play. All right, Sauer back to throw again and fakes to Dino Bell. Sets up the throw, and I think this is an interception. The ball is tipped in the air right there, and Sanji makes a play and picks off the tip and for his second interception. Scored a touchdown from that interception. Number one, the other quarterback, Sauer, gets hurt in the ball game running the option play, and they throw deep, and I think Dwight Drain, junior safety from Miami, Florida, Huskies right there, at three deep safety, and we get possession of the football there. Option play, pitch the ball, Gary Lowell, come hit him right there. Dino Bell, that's Kerwin, number four. Hits him for about a 7-yard loss in the ball game. Good defensive play and a strong safety.
A lot of big plays. Takes a lot of big plays in a game like Kansas football game.
Well, I think, you want to have the big ball, big plays in every game, Steve, but, Nebraska and this week and all the other games we've got to play, we're going to have more big plays than we had this week. You know, we won that ball game because we were much better. But the big plays have got to come in this stretch of the next five ball games.
Yeah, Coach, one of the things that's been in the paper this week a little bit is the Freddie Sims. And I think part of it on Freddie is that, a little bit of misquoted. I know how a player feels sometimes, but I commend you for the way that you handled that situation.
Well, I was disappointed in some of the things that were in the press today, and I'm disappointed myself. Not that I was misquoted, but they actually occurred. We beat Kansas, we come back, and a sports writer from Tucson, Arizona talked to Freddie. Freddie told me, he said, Coach, the only thing I told him, I want to play high back, and if I don't get that opportunity, I might consider transferring next year. Fine. I'm glad he told me. He has those feelings and expresses them. But all the other statements he said he never made in the paper, and I can understand how those things happened in 25 years in this business. Well, today in the paper, I think there were things said that, well, I don't care if Freddie leaves. Well, that's not true. I want all our good players to stay. I want all the players to stay. But the question was asked me, if he does leave, if Freddie wants to leave, then we're going to play some other players. We're going to have some other players to play, and that's what happens. But that's not going to happen. Freddie's a very talented player, and good players find a place to play, and he'll play and do well in his career.
Yeah, well, I wanted you to have a chance to mention that because I do commend you on the way you handled it. We've got a special feature now. Quarterbacks, halfbacks, all of us really like it when the offensive linemen get their credit. Well, they get their credit tonight. We've got this little piece on Merv Johnson and the offensive line.
Merv Johnson, OU's assistant head coach and the man in charge of the offensive line. His job on game day, making one mountain move another.
It'll be a real quick block. They gave a stretch look, and Johnny should block the guy over him, and then you've got a real quick block on the end.
Trap. I went for took the inside path and closed down in.
All right, well, next time influence, unless he lines up wider. They went into goal line defense down there now. You had a guy on you and a five technique tackle. You hadn't seen anything we really hadn't worked on, have you? We got to keep the pressure on them now. You've got to feel for what they're doing. Come off hard at his inside shoulder. If he goes outside on 34, let's go through and get on the back. Come on, we got to hook it up again. Now let's go.
Very few fans watch the offensive lineman during a game. They watch the ball. But when that ball gets from the line of scrimmage to the goal line, there are several reasons behind it, including the work of seven men up front and their teacher on the sideline.
Zone block and a fullback on the left side. We had him sealed awfully well. Good job. Good job on the traps this week. Keep it going. Keep it going. Let's don't get out there and get sloppy in our play now. Let's keep it going. Keep the pressure on.
Last Saturday, Oklahoma ran 86 offensive plays. That means seven linemen together making about 600 carefully planned collisions if the Sooners are going to win.
Like this, and I was going to block him, but he cheated all the way down.
Wait a minute. You got the zone now. Anytime he's out over you, you get on that backer.
I did.
I know it, but I thought you said you were going to block him.
No,
you're always going to block the linebacker. Okay. Be alert for this down in here, Scott. Now, the up back got it blocked right. You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, and then you got the next guy. Mitch, you got the next. You got the next guy. That should be an easy one with two outside of you. Now, we all straight? Okay.
The satisfaction of being up front, playing on the line, is not glamorous, but it's very real and very basic. If they win most of the collisions, move that mountain of opposition, the team wins. If not, they lose. It's that simple. OU moved its third mountain in a row last Saturday.
Toughest phase in football to coach and toughest to play offensive line.
And that group of linemen have been pretty much criticized all year long for not having a lot of talent, not being playing very well. But it seems like the change in the offense and the confidence they're building and the Texas game, all those type of things, have made this offensive line kind of pull together.
No matter who you are, you get better every time you practice and play. And we're young in our talent. We were young at tackle position. I've always thought that the two guards in our center position were pretty solid. They're good players there. But this is the seventh week, Steve, that we have not started the same offensive line. Mm-hmm. We're consistent. This is a different unit than has played for seven consecutive weeks now.
Are you feeling a little bit more at home with the I formation now and trying to expand it a little
more?
We're
expanding as we go along. We're doing some more things, involve all of our backs, the wing back into it on the counters and traps, reverses, things like this that they need to become involved in because they're talented too. And the I formation is a two-back offense, the fullback and the I. For some people, for like OSU, it's a one-back offense. And most I teams use the fullback as a big, strong blocker, budding linebackers, kicking ends out, and power plays, blast plays, things like that. And it's blocking the sweep with the fullbacks on the cornerbacks, and they very seldom get to carry the football. Ask Mike Harper, that used to play fullback for Steve Owens. But what we do is we utilize both backs. It's a two-back offense where the wishbone is a four-back offense, where you're using the quarterback option play and the other back. But we're using both formations, and without a question, they're helping our offense. We're producing yardage, we're scoring points, and it forces and gives our opponent more problems to work with in the practice week of practice and in the ballgame.
Well, we've got two of those backs, those two backs you're talking about, the fullback and the tailback, here tonight, and we'll, after this word from Kerr-McGee, we're going to talk to them.
Gone for main engine start. We have main engine start.
On April 12, 1981, NASA sent America's first space shuttle, the Columbia, on its maiden flight into space. Kerr-McGee played a vital role in that momentous first, and will do so on the flights that follow by supplying ammonium perchlorate, the oxidizer used in the space shuttle's solid rocket boosters. Kerr-McGee's 11,000 employees are working hard to keep America a leader in energy here on Earth and a leader in outer space.
Coach, you've got two very special people here today.
Two good ones. On my right here, across from me, is Marcus Dupree from Philadelphia, Mississippi, the freshman, and the old pro over there, Stanley Wilson, been around for four years, starter since his freshman year, from Los Angeles, California, a fullback.
Guys, welcome to the show tonight. Stanley, you're the senior. We've got to talk to you a little bit. Marcus, you'll get your turn. You've got three years left. Stanley, you've made a position change this week, and of course, I mean, how do you feel about making that position change?
Well, it was sort of different for me. It was kind of hard to swallow at first, but when I got back into my stands playing fullback, it was different, but it was familiar. So,
one of the things, go ahead.
I just know it's the best thing for the team, so I'm ready to go all out for it.
That was one of the comments I wanted to make, that you, almost without question, every time you've been questioned about making position changes, you've always said for the team, and I commend you for that. All of us former players really think highly of you for that. Marcus, you're the rookie. I wanted to ask you one question. What have been the major changes in coming from Philadelphia, Mississippi to the University of Oklahoma? What adjustments have you had to make?
Well, just meeting a lot of different people and practicing. It's pace of practice.
Was it a lot different in Philadelphia than practice?
You practice just like you do at Philadelphia. I talk to you every day about learning how to practice.
Well...
He'll get better.
Yeah. When you're looking at when you were in high school and looking at the different kind of players that were playing both college ball and pro ball, and comparing your running style, what player do you kind of think that you favor a little bit?
Well, I hadn't really decided on one player. I try to be like all of them. Try to have a little bit of style of Billy Sims and all them, you know, Earl Campbell type. Mm-hmm. Just try to roll it all into one.
A lot of people compare you to Herschel Walker. What do you think about that?
Well, we have basically the same running style.
Mm-hmm. Herschel's a little taller, I think, than Marcus. I think Marcus is heavier than Herschel. Mm-hmm. Of course, Herschel's got great sprinter speed. Marcus, he played baseball, and you know, he didn't even work at track. And, of course, Herschel's a class sprinter, I guess, about a 10-200 meter mm-hmm. sprinter, which is great speed. But both of them got good enough football speed to score from 50, 60, 70 yards out.
Yeah. Stanley, what do you think about the team thus far? Because there were a lot of things said about this football team. It seems like they've gelled. All of you have gelled.
Well, I think we've got a lot more confidence. And, you know, being on previous teams I've been on, this team was lacking confidence. And I think after we had a big win against Texas, they knew that great feeling they can have of beating a good quality team like Texas. And I think we're just all up. Going downhill from here.
I think Stanley's right there, Steve. You know, Stanley has been a part of winning big ball games. He's won two championships, started for us a freshman, went to two Orange Bowls, won both those Orange Bowls. He's beaten some good football teams. He's been a part of that experience. And Stanley's comment right there is something that the other players hadn't shared in. Right. And he's had a taste mm-hmm. of it before. But that locker room at the Texas game has kind of brought back old memories. It's kind of like old times, you know, when you beat Nebraska and you win the Orange Bowl. And our young players have never been a part of something like mm-hmm. that. And it'll be something that'll be meaningful to them the rest of their career. And they'll know what it's like and maybe the little extra to make mm-hmm. those things happen mm-hmm. again.
Marcus, Texas, that football game is a game that everybody's kind of looked at as saying it was a real driving force in making this team kind of pull together and play even more inspired football. Have you ever seen anything like the Oklahoma-Texas game?
Well, not really.
Philadelphia Meridian. That's big, isn't it?
But you just haven't seen anything like it.
The fans just went wild.
What are you two... think about the rest of the season and what's coming up. What things have to happen? Stanley, for you, what do you think has to happen to the team to continue to set up the game with Nebraska, besides win?
Well, I think we need to go out early and establish ourselves and just get more confidence. We haven't really worked together as a team yet. You know, mm-hmm. we still have people in and out each week. And I think we just go out there each week and improve every game because we're still not the kind of team that we still like to be.
Mm-hmm. Marcus, this will be your first start this week. Did you think it would happen this soon, or do you feel like that you would start early in the year, or do you feel like you're on track with kind of what you set your own personal goals?
Well, I didn't think I was going to start any this year. I just wanted to contribute to the team, you know, just play a part of a winning team.
Yeah. Well, both of you are outstanding football players. Stanley, you've proven yourself over and over again, week after week, year after year, and congratulations to you. And it'll be good to see you back at the fullback position. It's not so bad making a lot of yards from fullback. Marcus, best of luck to you, because certainly you've got an outstanding career ahead of you. There's a lot of good guys that have played there.
You see you in the orange bowl.
All right, that's fine. Well, I want to be there.
CBS doesn't get there.
But I want to be there. There's no doubt about it. Fellas, thanks for being on the show tonight. We're going to be right back after a great word from the fine folks at Kerr-McGee.
What do you know about Kerr-McGee? For instance, Kerr-McGee people made the first commercial discovery of oil out of sight of land. The year was 1947. Why is that important now? Because the same innovative desire to find and develop natural resources for your use is still the moving force of Kerr-McGee today. Kerr-McGee people are working on this multi-million dollar drilling rig and others like it, probing under the ocean for oil. When oil is found, this rig will be removed. And in its place, a Kerr-McGee production platform is set to keep the oil flowing. That quick look at how offshore oil is discovered and produced is also a quick look at one way the work of Kerr-McGee people affects your life. Some Kerr-McGee people work here, some in oil refineries in Corpus Christi, Texas, and Wynnewood, Oklahoma, some in service stations throughout Mid-America. But wherever you find Kerr-McGee people, you find people at work with oil, gas, coal, uranium, forest products, and chemicals, putting natural resources to work for you.
Probably one of the surprises this year, Coach, is that Oklahoma State's not played up to their potential. Let's hope that this isn't the week that they decide to play their potential.
Well, that concerns me. You know, they're due, and they're 1-2-2. No one certainly anticipated or expect that. They certainly didn't, and they're a much more talented football team than their record. You know, I really believe that they have more talent, athletes, at particular positions on offense and defense, and not a lot of them, but a lot of key players that are very talented players that are good as in a group than anybody except Nebraska we've got left to play. I think they're tight end. I don't know whether he's hurt now or not or whether he'll get to play, but their tight end is a great threat. He is the best tight end in the Big 8 Conference. Ernest Anderson's a great running back. There's no doubt about his ability to play and perform. Their quarterbacks are talented, but they're young. They've got some receivers that can catch the football, and that may be great blazing speed. But they run good routes, they catch the ball, an offensive unit, the line that's played together. And defensively, they got some key defensive personnel, Lewis, Harding, Green. They've got some good physical people that are good defensive football players.
Well, let's take a look at Oklahoma State and see what they're going to bring to Norman this week, the Cowboys.
And it's Colorado. I tell you what, you know, they should have beaten Colorado. They give them 20 points. You know, they throw the football. Colorado better not count on getting 20 from us like that. They'll be out there a long time for us to throw that many interceptions. But, you know, Oklahoma State moved the ball on Colorado. Here's Ernest Anderson. He's got great – he slips here. He's got great quickness. He jumps around and makes plays and makes things happen.
He's averaging 208 yards a game.
Throw the ball well right there.
And
big
six
play.
Yards a carry. Not bad.
Dump the ball off here, that speed back right there, Ken Zachary, I believe, from Sepulpa, freshman. His shot right there, it's a big play. Split backs out of the eye, and he scrambles around right here, and they get in his face, and if he founds Comer right there in the end zone for a touchdown, that's the go-ahead touchdown.
Has it been easy this week to keep the attention of the athletes, your team, and say, fellas, this is not Oklahoma State at 1-2-2. They're a better football team.
I think
team.
That. You know, this is their Texas, I'd like to say. This is their big game for them, and they would like to win it. Our football team always gets ready to play OSU. Always has, Steve, when you played there. We get ready to play OSU. We've always done that, and I like to think that we're going to do that again this week. We've got them at home. We've been on the road. We haven't won a game in Memorial Stadium, Owen Field, in the last three starts there. So we're 0-3, and we need to get something going. We need to keep our same act we've got going on the road at home. So it's something I think that we'll be shooting for.
Coach, the conference schedule has kind of been shaping up kind of interesting. It looks like that there's some opportunity there to gain some real confidence in the next few weeks and lead up to what you've been talking about all year, the Nebraska game.
Well, I think, you know, we're improving as a football team. I really think we're going to get better every week. Mm-hmm. This team hasn't reached its potential yet. Right. We're in the learning stages of a lot of things that we're doing, and because of the youth, they have so much further to go than a senior and experienced player. You know, a sophomore has got a lot of ground to cover before he can play to his ability and performance of his senior year. So we're going to make leaps and strides, I think, in some areas in our football team. And it was like Stanley said, we gain more confidence as we play and go along. And that's so important. You know, I really believe, you know, our players thinking we're getting pretty good now. And I like that. I like that attitude because they're going to do the things that are necessary and the coaches are going to watch and see that they do.
That's right.
That allow us an opportunity to win.
Well, it's nothing but Big Eight games in the future. Let's take a look at the teams down the road. Colorado, they've struggled, but Colorado and Oklahoma State tied last week.
25-25. You know, our league has had more ties in the history of the league this year. Then, of course, Nebraska 42-13. They kind of whip up on everybody.
Kansas State comes to town after that.
You know, they tied Missouri. Kansas State tied Missouri. Missouri had 2 weeks in a row, two ties. Iowa State tied last week. The week before last, there were more ties in Division I of college football than the history of intercollegiate football.
Anybody on that schedule besides in those next few games that really concern you?
Yeah, they all concern me, Steve, but I know who looms at the end of the schedule. They're the ones you got to beat. You know, mm-hmm. to be champions of the Big Eight Conference, the bowl games, those are the big red imposters of mm-hmm. the North, I call them.
Yeah. Real quickly, Coach, we talked with Stanley and Marcus. Marcus is really emerging as to being a great talent.
Marcus is, you know, I've talked to him this week. I think that Marcus, without a question, is a great freshman back. Mm-hmm. But to say he's in the class of some of the other backs that we've had yet, it's not fair pressure to put that young man under. He gets an opportunity the next five games to prove what type of football player he is, because I want to see how he runs north mm-hmm. and south in the dark holes and the thick holes. Can he make a lot of 6, 7, 8 yard gains? I know he made the 75 on the corner mm-hmm. when things are blocked for him. But the key will be, can he slash up inside and make things happen? And it's like Daryl Royal said, all great backs look the same when there's no place to run. And we're going to find out what Marcus looks like when there's no place
That's
to
right.
run.
Well, we're going to get a chance to see Marcus and a lot of other good players play Saturday down in Norman. If you can't watch the Sooners play on Saturday, be sure and watch a local high school game on Friday night. Coach, your
Man,
turn.
And when you got to go to that game, you got to get some Kerr-McGee gas or you'll never make it.
We'll see you next week on the Barry Switzer Show.
We beat Texas.
The Barry Switzer Show has been brought to you by Kerr-McGee Corporation, putting natural resources to work for you. Ground transportation for the Barry Switzer Show crew provided by Hertz Buy-A-Car, Oklahoma City, and Tulsa. Clothes for Barry Switzer and Steve Davis come from Harold's, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa. Studio furnishings provided by Landsaws of Norman.